Now, as I told you, there are only two questions which can be asked for 5 marks in sexual reproduction in flowering plants. One is TS of anther, second one is anatropous ovule. Okay, LS of anatropous ovule, that is longitudinal section of anatropous ovule. Stigma is the receptacle where pollen grain will come and settle. Style is a place where pollen tube will penetrate. Ovary is the one which will actually develop into fruit. Within ovary, there are ovules. And what is the structure of that ovule? There are different shapes. Orthotropous, anatropous, hemianatropous, circinotropous, campylotropous, amphitropous. But we are going to draw anatropous ovule. Okay. How exactly to draw this particular diagram? See, the very first thing what you need to know is you need to draw one egg-shaped structure. Imagine one person goes to Tirupati, ya phir koi haji sahab haj ko gaye, he'll go bald. Right? After going bald, this person starts wearing a cap. Will put a cap on his head. Okay? But ye cap badi ajeeb cap hai. This particular cap is also having hair onto it, like wig. So we'll put, what do you say, central line on the head, and then beech wali maang nikalenge yahan se, both the sides. And here we'll draw one just outrageous structure, like we're just drawing a wave over here. Then connect this to the other side. That completes the diagram. Very simple diagram. But if you do not label it, you don't get any marks. How to label it? See, the stalk of the ovule is known as funicle. The so-called funicle gets connected to ovule with this structure called as hilum. So hilum is a structure which is connecting funicle with that of ovule. Then this structure, this pore over here, is known as micropylar end, and this is known as micropyle. So micropyle, and this is also known as micropylar end. Now, according to PU board, pre-university board in Karnataka, they give half mark for each labeling. So we need to make sure that at least we write 10 labelings over here. If we miss even a single labeling, half mark has been reduced. Okay? So make sure that you remember 10 labelings. So accurately, every part should be labeled. Now, these structures, the waves what we drew, the hairs what we drew over here are known as integument. This is outer integument. Followed by that, we have inner integument. Integuments are the parts which will develop into seed coat. The outer husk layer on a seed, the one which has been rubbed and then it has been thrown. So husk part is basically integuments. Then we have nutritive tissue. This nutritive tissue is known as nucellus. Nucellus is nutritive tissue which will supply its nutrition to developing embryo sac. So this one is embryo sac. Embryo sac can also be written as female gametophyte. Okay. Then the base of the ovule is known as chalazal end. Now if we count totally, there are 9 labelings being given in textbook. NCRT, if you check out, these are the labelings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But as I told you, in pre-university board, half mark has been given for each labeling. So from where shall I get another one? What I'll do over here is, like, from here, I'm going to connect a specialized tissue called as raphe, which will connect to bottom. So I'll write it as raphe. Some people might tell that this is not there in NCRT, so how will they give us marks? So if you want something from NCRT, then start drawing inside part. Like in next video, I'll teach you how to draw embryo sac. Okay? So here we have egg apparatus, a rough diagram. I'm just going to draw a rough diagram over here. We have egg apparatus on the top, then polar nuclei at the center, antipodal cells at the bottom. Okay? This is how the structure looks like. Okay? Very important structure. Now, sometimes they'll ask you directly to draw a neat label diagram of anatropous ovule. ठीक है, anatropous ovule. But sometimes they'll ask you to explain anatropous ovule. Or they can ask you both, draw a neat label diagram and then explain. How will you explain? A typical anatropous ovule has got a stalk called as funicle, which will connect itself to the wall of ovary. Okay? Then you'll write hilum. Hilum is a part which is connecting funicle with that of ovule. Then you'll write the so-called integument, outer integument, inner integument. Both integuments together will develop into seed coat. Outer integument will develop into testa. Inner integument will develop into tegmen. Okay, so these are the two wall layers, like your hands. Outer part is dark, inner part is light. So outer is testa, inner is tegmen. Just imagine that this is seed coat. Then the layer names will be as such. Then nucellus is nutritive tissue of developing embryo sac. Micropyle is the small pore present on this ovule. Chalazal end is the base of ovule. And then raphe, it's not been given in textbook, but it is the layer which has got xylem and phloem running into it. Okay, then embryo sac can be explored. In the next diagram, I would explore the structure of embryo sac.